Hello, friends. Welcome or welcome back to Shadow Play Tarot. Thank you so much for joining me here today, friends. If you are new to the channel, welcome. Make yourselves at home. Thank you for joining. And if you are returning, well, friends, you know I love you. Thank you so much for coming back and spending more of your precious time with me here on the channel, friends. It really means so much to me. I absolutely cannot believe that we are jumping into November horoscopes. Insane that we are literally facing the end of the year. I know this year for me was interesting. Parts of it went pretty slow and other parts I blinked and it was gone. So you guys will have to let me know how you're feeling about that. Really, it's almost holidays. The holidays are coming and it is almost New Year's. It is exciting to get a fresh start though. So here's to 2023, that it brings us all abundance, health, joy, happiness, all those things that we're after. All right, my friends, before we jump into our horoscopes, I also want to just address, obviously, I address this pretty randomly and pretty often, but there are so many scam accounts out there. I appreciate when you guys let me know over on Instagram that there's a scammer asking me if this other account is me. The answer is always no. The only two accounts that I do have are here on the screen. One is my public account and the other one is my private tarot account where I mostly post tarot memes and I post what readings I'm doing first there or there first. You know what I'm trying to say. I will never approach you to try to convince you to get a reading. I probably won't follow you back. They do like to go through, they meaning the scammers, they like to go through and see who recently followed me and then they'll follow you back and then they'll try to scam you. So just letting you guys know, no, it is not me. But that's all the energy I want to give that. I really just want to focus on our readings now. So my friends, let's get right to it. This month, we are going to be covering general messages, love messages. We're going to see what comes through for you. We'll be pulling some oracle cards and then doing a little charm reading at the end. So let's dive right in. Let's get going. Hello, my Aries babies, and welcome to your November horoscope reading, friends. As always, we have a lot to cover this month. We'll be starting with general messages for the month of November and see what's coming up for you. See what important things you need to know about. And then we'll be moving to the love portion of your reading. We'll be pulling messages for singles and then those of you that are connected. We'll be doing a bonus reading to check in on the person on your mind all the way from Aries to Pisces. And then wrapping the party up with a little charm reading. All right, friends. So let's begin. As always, let's start with a moment of gratitude. Thank you, Spirit, for allowing me to channel these messages today for my Aries friends for the month of November, Spirit. General messages for Aries. What's coming up for them in November? What do they need to know about, Spirit? Messages for Aries, please, in November. Messages for Aries, please. General messages for Aries, please, in November, Spirit. What can you tell us? What's coming up for them? Oh, these have been wild. What's coming up for them, Spirit? All right. We have the Justice card. That came out first. So it's like I feel like some of you are cutting your feelings out, your emotions out, and you're just doing what needs to be done, quite frankly. It feels like you're just bringing balance back to a situation. There's a sense of excitement here, new opportunity approaching, and an overall feeling of getting out of your head. So I kind of feel like there's a relief, but we'll see what this is about. What's coming up for Aries, please? Yeah, because there is an ending, like something painfully had to come to an end. And now it's like time to big daddy energy. This is you guys. You're doing what needs to be done. You're taking care of business. This is business owner energy. yeah, it's handling it, to be honest. You could be dealing with someone that's younger than you. Don't have to be if there is other people involved. But more than anything, I just see that you're excited. So whatever needs to be done, or what? Yeah, I feel like whatever needs to be done, it's like for the good, for the better good is what I'm getting. You're just being responsible. I do think that there was anxiety or fears, a lot of thoughts, lots and lots of thoughts, getting in your head, processing, when it comes to whatever this is. So we do have a Queen of Pentacles showing up with a King of Pentacles. So this is like divine counterparts. So for those of you, dealing with work situation, this could be like, there's a head higher up, and then there's someone who's like below them with, not below them, but you know, chain of command level, that's coming through. But like I said, it's like they're both feeling very grounded. Both of these energies are grounded. Now, if this isn't another person, this is just showing you like you're doing what needs to be done. Financially, everything's good. You're handling your business and you're literally cutting emotion out. Regardless, I do feel a lot of you are pushing feelings aside type of energy. It's like this is the healing that's going to happen after something that was painful. I was going to say why the Eight of Swords in reverse. So you're getting out of your head when it comes to something about communication. Maybe it's not talking about feelings or just holding back feelings. There's just like, I don't want to hear it anymore. We're pushing that aside. Why the Ten of Swords? You could have felt, okay, so this is signaling an end of a time where you felt powerless in a situation, but this also kind of feels like some of you could have felt like, there was an ending that it could have been led to because of a level of manipulation with that magician in reverse. Why the King of Pentacles? Yeah, this is you taking action. I do feel you guys are going to be steering this, whatever it is. You don't want something anymore, and you're really inspired and motivated to get going. If for those of you that it does involve another person, I just don't think that there is union or you guys are seeing eye to eye, and it's almost like, you know what you got to do for, some like long-term goal or long-term stability or the good of your family. All right. Wow. Lots of pentacle energy, which is, Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. We're also getting Leo, Aries, Sag. Let me see if there's anything else that's coming through. No, I think we got now they're showing me the same thing. Some of you, this could be not for everyone, but maybe if it's a marriage, there's like something going on with that where both people are doing what's best. I'm getting very mature energy. All right, let's continue. Libra coming through with that justice as well. That could also, for some of you, feel like this is going into, maybe this started in Libra season. Yeah, that's what I was going to say, because we're in Scorpio now, and then we're going to be moving into Sagittarius soon. All right, thank you, Spirit, for those general messages for my Aries babies. What about for my Aries, my single Aries friends? What can you tell me about them in the month of November? Love messages for the single Aries in November, please. Love messages for the single Aries. All right, there you are, Aries, with that Emperor card. Is there a lot of people fighting for your attention? It feels like there is. It feels like there's other people. It doesn't feel like things are going anywhere with that or moving forward, but maybe you do get the attention of people because they just like, yeah, because you don't feel the same. So I do feel you are going to be, there's almost like a fighting for your attention, but I don't think you feel the same. You might get messages from someone, or someone's not being upfront here. There might be something you don't know. We'll see what that is. Maybe someone's into you and you're not realizing it. Why the Emperor? You're like, I'm healing, I'm good, I'm strong, I'm taking control, hear me roar. Like, you are in your power. I like that. Why the Five of Wands? I do feel like there are people that are interested in you. Yeah, there's people that are interested in you, but they're holding back. For some of you, you might get an inkling of a second chance, but I don't know if someone here is fearful that you don't feel the same, or maybe you just don't feel the same. Yeah, someone's going to try to return. I don't think you see it coming, and there's fears here of what won't work out or you not wanting to work on things. Here's the thing. I mean, maybe you're the one taking control. Only you guys will know if you're approaching someone, but I get for most of you, this is someone you're focusing on your stuff. You're being you. And I feel like someone might be coming towards you. But like I said, I think feelings have been hidden here, and someone's thinking you don't feel the same. Or if you're the one approaching someone, maybe you're like, they don't feel the same. It does feel like it's past energy though. Yeah, someone here has been holding back how they feel. Romantically for you. They've been hiding that. This could be someone that you know through work. I feel like you see this person, but you don't see this person. I feel like they may be around you kind of regularly, or I don't know. Maybe they see you online. Like, it's hard to tell these days. But someone's been hiding how they feel. Will they reveal themselves to Aries? Someone loves you. I mean, unless this is you hiding your feelings for someone else. Someone really cares for you, but they're holding back. All right. If this is... what can you tell me about this person? Someone here felt like there was too many other people or options, or were confused. And now they're seeing things clearly. Will they be approaching Aries in November? No, they're real careful with what they say. They don't want to let on to how attracted they are to you. And they try to be real kind of cold. If you notice someone being a little awkward, they don't open up, but they're definitely holding on to this. Wow, this person... For someone, this person's fantasized a marriage with you, family. They're right in front of you, you guys. You don't see them. You don't see them. Oh, that's crazy. I'm like smiling over here because I've literally never had these kinds of messages. But I feel like this person is literally like, you see this person regularly. Even if it's someone random that you're just, you know... We have those online friends that we watch their stories, or they're watching yours, but something here has been hidden, that's for sure. What else do they want to tell me? So yeah, if you do talk to this person, you would never know it. Here's the thing, this person, they might be holding back because they're not single, but they are definitely want to come towards you. They're in their head about it. Yeah, you guys. So they don't have plans on coming forward. Like I said, they could be in a situation. I haven't done this for anyone else, but I'm invested. I'm invested here. All while Aries is just being their own powerful selves. I'm going to pull again for you guys. Like I said, I haven't done that for any of the other signs. But then again, you guys are my Aries babies. It's cool. All right, single Aries. What can you tell me about this person that has hidden feelings for my Aries? Or what can you tell me about that situation? Maybe that's my... So this person could be trying to get out of their own toxic relationship or situation. Maybe this is even something that you know about them, that they've been in a bad relationship for a while, and maybe they're finally starting to come out of that, or... Can you tell me about this person? Yeah, this person, I feel like they may have been like they watch you and how you go about your life or whatever. There's a lot of emotion that's here. They feel like they've had a lot of good, I don't know if a lot of good times or just like they've had fun with you, or there's something here. Maybe there's even a connection through friends. With this King of Pentacles in reverse, it just makes me feel like someone isn't available. Like I said, I feel like you guys know who this is. So them not being available or someone not being available is something that's weighing heavy on them. This person also has a lot of responsibilities that might take precedence. They have hung out with you or in the same group. They've been around you physically, but they didn't talk to you. If they did talk to you, you would never know. You would never know that they were feeling like this about you. Or the Queen of Cups. Oh my gosh, look. Look at that card was flipped over. They didn't take up an opportunity to talk to you when you guys were around each other. Where the Queen of Cups, please. Yeah, they did not talk to you. They stayed away. They view you as being really sweet and like loving and understanding. They like how you express your affection to your friends or like close friendships that you have. They admire that about you. Or they really like that. Yeah, this person, this person is, there might be an involvement with work or family or something like that. With this Ten of Pentacles, I do feel like they have something very stable, or they're being very smart right now, or they're trying to be smart, and that's why they haven't said anything. Interesting. Well, it's coming up for a reason in your reading, you guys. Please slide into my DMs. Leave me a comment. Let me know. Because I am so curious here. All right, friends, let's continue. Now let's get messages for my connected Aries babies. Thank you, Spirit. My connected Aries friends. Love messages, please, for my Aries that are connected to someone. Love messages for November, please. Love messages. Love messages for my connected Aries. We have the Seven of Pentacles in reverse. It just kind of popped out. We have the Nine of Cups in reverse. Messages for my connected Aries, please. Interesting. It feels like, first of all, the energy almost feels like it's being pulled back. It's like you haven't gotten something that you wanted or something that you're wishing for. For some of you, maybe children are involved or someone is younger than you, or there's an emotionally immature energy or like approach that we're taking to something. There's also a feeling here of, I'm not sure if some of you are cutting things out because it feels like you've been wasting your time, money, energy, love, whatever it is. Or I'm almost getting the feeling that your feelings aren't being prioritized. That's for someone. Messages for connected Aries, please. Yeah, you guys are just pulling back because it's too much of a burden. We have the Two of Cups. There's your connection. Maybe you guys were just doing too much, working too much, or had too much on your plate. We'll see. Why the Seven of Pentacles? And that could be, so some of you are going to be, I don't know, weird message. It's almost like you feel like you wasted your time on something and there's a feeling of loss or regret that's coming through. Why the Nine of Cups in reverse? Why the Page of Cups in reverse? Why the Hangman? Why the Ten of Wands in reverse? Okay, so for some of you, this was a new beginning that was supposed to happen. Not for everyone. This is for someone. It feels like it's pregnancy related. If that hasn't happened for you, it feels like you've just been kind of repeating a cycle, like, okay, now we wait. And that's this hangman energy with the Wheel of Fortune in reverse. It's like, we've been here before. We've done this before. Your connection on its own, it does feel like it's strong and you guys are on the same page. So whatever this is, it feels like you understand each other. This moon in reverse, I'm not sure if this feels like you guys are starting to see things clearly or you kind of gain a different understanding after some time though, because it feels like this new beginning that you wanted to happen or something that was just burdening you over starting new or a new chapter in the situation, it's not coming to fruition in November. I do feel that you are in your feels about it. But like I said, I feel like you guys are understanding each other. There's a sense here of it's hard to stay positive. Now, if this isn't like about something as big as pregnancy, this just kind of feels like someone here's not really understanding or not connected really to how they feel. Maybe they're ignoring how they feel, and that's what's bringing on this sun in reverse, the sense of negativity. What else for my connected Aries? Yeah, something here. So either whatever this was supposed to take off not happening, that was a shock or a surprise. I'm going to put that there. And then it's like you're recovering after that, or you're just kind of like, I'm getting like picking up the pieces, or like, now what? And it's like, now we wait. And it's like, that's something that's repeating again. I do think you are going to be, there is movement forward, and there's also, if communication needs to be had, I do feel you guys are communicating and it's very truthful. So I do feel like this moon in reverse and the seven of swords in reverse, this is revealing something that we weren't seeing before, we weren't acknowledging before, we weren't taking into consideration. Maybe it's like, what's our priorities? What's important here? What do we want to invest into? Because there's been something here that we've been doing that hasn't gotten us the result that we want. Yeah, I feel like it's been repeating. So I don't see you moving forward this month. Something here, it feels like it's not going to move forward. So if you guys were planning something or something new was supposed to take off, I don't feel like November is going to be the time for it. I keep getting signs of like a stop sign. Yeah, it doesn't feel like it's going. They keep showing me over and over. Six of swords in reverse and the full reverse and the knight of cups in reverse. It's like holding back, not moving forward. All right, my Aries friends, whatever that situation is regarding, yeah, only take what resonates. This is, I almost called it a team reading, not again, a collective reading. All right, let's check in on you and the person on your mind. Who is this person on your mind? Aries through Pisces. In the month of November, Spirit, can you tell us the person that Aries is thinking about? Aries through Pisces, what can you tell us? Spirit, if my Aries are dealing with another Aries in November, what can you tell us? Aries dealing with an Aries. Things aren't moving forward, at least not in November. Someone here could be holding back. If there was travel plans, it doesn't seem. Yeah, not taking an opportunity, perhaps. Aries dealing with a Taurus. It's unbalanced here. Someone gave more than the other, or someone here, feelings aren't reciprocated, whether yours or theirs. Aries dealing with a Gemini. There's a block in emotion, like emotional renewal, or a block in emotions. Aries dealing with a Cancer. A lack of commitment, or just not being able to commit or build towards something stable. Also, someone here could not be thinking about the long term, depending on what the nature of your connection is. Aries dealing with a Leo. There's conflict here and tension, maybe even competition surrounding the situation. Depending on what's going on, it could be sexual tension as well. Aries dealing with a Virgo. There's a new beginning, or they want a new beginning to take a leap of faith, a new start. Aries dealing with a Libra. They can't let it go, or someone here can't let it go, even though someone has tried. Aries dealing with a Scorpio. They're exhausted, but they haven't given up. They're still persevering. Maybe someone here is exhausted because of work. They feel like you guys have been through a lot. Aries dealing with a Sagittarius. They're holding back. They might be holding back their passion. Aries dealing with a Capricorn. This is like F-boy energy. They're not committed. They're kind of selfish. They want what they want when they want it. Out for their pleasure and benefit, my friends. Aries dealing with an Aquarius. Someone's taking a break from this, staying away, staying back. Aries dealing with a Pisces, please. They're not really talking. I don't really see too much talking, but it still feels like they feel connected. That's the Pisces card as well. All right, friends. Let's get some charms for you before we wrap up your reading. Thank you, Spirit, for these messages. What else can we tell my Aries friends in November? All right, let's see what we got here. We have a Krusty's Clown Liquor. Maybe someone here. There's a Simpsons connection, or you live by a liquor store or frequent one. We have amigos. Maybe there's friends connected to your situation, or maybe you like the show Friends. We have Sexy MF from Minnesota. The year is 1992. The month is June. This is also a Prince pin. Maybe someone likes Prince. We have Robert Smith from The Cure. Maybe someone here has been listening to The Cure. I think of Boys Don't Cry. I also just thought of Love Cats. I love that song. And we have Nomi Malone. Thanks. I bought it at Versace. Someone here might be buying themselves something nice this month. I literally never get that. But all of a sudden, I was like, hey, I feel like someone might be treating themselves to something designer. Well, that's nice, my Aries friends. Treat yourselves. We have the haha clown pin. You guys, there's two clowns here. And also, this pin is usually about hiding who you truly are. So someone here might be hiding. Oh, wait, didn't we just talk about someone's hiding their feelings for you? Oh, you guys, I literally forget right after I say it because I'm channeling. I'm still going to go back to it. It's right in front of your face, guys. Or it's been right in front of your face. And you just would never know. Maybe you would know. Maybe you know who I'm already talking about, but they think you don't know. And we have the chamango pin. Maybe someone here is in need of a chamango or recently had one, or tamarindo, chamoy, anything like that. And then we have aplacate, February 86, vintage California plate. This is Spanish slang for basically calm the F down. Maybe that's what someone needs to do here. All right, my friends, only you'll know, but I'm wishing the best November for you, sending you guys so many hugs, and I'll catch you at the next one. Thanks, guys. Hello, my Leo babies, and welcome to your November horoscope reading, friends. Let's get right to it. Today, as always, we're going to start with general messages. We're going to be looking into what's coming up for you in the month of November. What's of importance that you need to know? And then we'll be moving into the second portion of your reading, which is, of course, the love reading. We'll be pulling cards for singles, as well as those of you that are already connected, or connect connecting to someone. I don't know, whatever level of your connection is. We'll see what messages we can get for you today. And then I will also be doing the bonus part of your reading, which is where we check in on you and the person on your mind. We'll go all the way from Aries to Pisces, and then we'll be wrapping the party up with a little charm reading. All right, my friends, let's begin. As always, with a moment of gratitude, thank you, Spirit, for allowing me to channel these messages today for my Leo babies, the Leos in November. Spirit, general messages for Leos. What's coming up for them in November? What do they need to know about, Spirit? Leos in November. Leos in November, please. What do they need to know? Messages. Messages from my Leos, please. Oh, this deck is acting funny. Are you guys acting funny? All right. It's your emotions, my Leos. All right. Let's see what's going on here. It feels like emotionally, when it comes to love, you guys could be just like holding back or just not sure how you feel. So I don't know. Make sure, my Leos, if you are connected or, you know, just trying to get your way with someone, it doesn't even have to be romantic. Just don't try to pressure anyone to do anything or, you know, you're promising things that you're not really sure you can deliver on when it comes to emotions, whatever that means. I just have there's an energy here that doesn't feel right. It's like, it's almost like someone here is trying to control something because they love or they care so much, but it's like not coming from the best place. It's weird. I'm also just kind of feeling like you guys may just be emotional during this time. There could be a disconnect or this is weird. It's like a lack of drama. I don't know. It feels like, or maybe you're pulling back your love in order to, because there was drama. This could be even friends as well, because it feels like it's a little group of people. As you can see, there's lots of people already showing up with the three here and the five there. Now we have King of Wands. That's you. I almost said King of Wongs. That's hilarious. I've never said that. What is going on? My ear is ringing too. Who has the sinus pressure? My head's just feeling so congested out of nowhere as soon as I started doing your reading. All right. I do feel you guys are going to be having an opportunity that's coming up. So maybe this is just saying love is on the back burner. I do feel you're kind of in your feels over something, whether it's drama with your friends or you're not able to, I don't know, have fun or enjoy or get together. It just feels here that you're maybe dropping something when it comes to other people and emotionally you're feeling it. But when it comes to going after an opportunity, you're like on it. So this could even be like, so for some of you, like, don't promise a friend you're going to do something with them because that's something you may not be able to like keep, like just, you know, leave your plans a little bit open. Because it almost feels like you guys are going to be choosing to do something else. For some of you, this could be work-related. Here you are again. So you're the one that's in your feels, in your emotions. I feel like you're holding back your love to avoid drama for some of you. Why the Knight of Cups in reverse? Why the Five of Wands in reverse? So some of you are, this isn't for everyone, but someone here is almost like feeling like you're not standing out in a crowd. Maybe there's something work-related that you need to stand out in a crowd, and that kind of has you in your feels as well. Because it just feels like there's something here that has you in your thoughts. So again, let's go back to you. Like, don't promise something that you may not be able to keep, or even like if it comes to, I don't know, guys, the feeling of holding back love or holding back emotions, or like, again, saying something that we don't really mean. These are all energies that are coming through. So just kind of be aware of that, because I do see that you do mean well, but there's something here that I feel you're going to be choosing instead. I do think it's going to make you feel excited. It is going to make you take action, be assertive, and maybe even take decisions or make some kind of decisions. And it feels like you're the one calling the shots over here. Yeah, I don't think you're going to be able to be too social this month. I mean, obviously it's a collective reading, but whoever's energy I'm picking up on, it's almost like there's something that you're going to have to do on your own and like no one else is involved. But at the same time, you get a little bit in your head about it. So, you know, only take what resonates. I'm really getting the sense that someone here is going to be starting a new venture or have the opportunity to get going on something. I feel like it's creative, or it just kind of it kind of fires up that side of you, like the creative side. You're excited. You're really doing it. I feel like you're doing it on your own. This is going to be a transformative energy for you, meaning I don't necessarily think this is here yet. I think it's going to be coming up for you. Yeah, this is something that you want, but it's going to require your quick action, you guys. It's going to require quick action, and this is an interesting message for those of you that this does resonate. It's almost like you're going to have to just go with what you want to do or what you feel is right. You're going to have to take action, and it's almost like you're either not going to be listening to family or thinking really long term. It's almost like you're just going to be figuring things out as you go. But it's not like I'm not getting full energy. I'm just getting that it's going to really require your attention. So I do feel like you may be breaking plans with someone or not. I don't think you're choosing this other stuff. I think your focus is going to be here, and I think it's going to be a really good opportunity for you. Again, just keep in mind though, that because at the rate you're going to be moving, just, you know, kind of check in on yourself, make sure that you're not missing something or not seeing something, creating conflict perhaps because you're not really communicating because yeah, this is unexpected. This is totally unexpected, and you guys are going to, I'm sorry, it just feels like someone might get upset, or someone here is upset that this is taking precedence over whatever this is, guys. I just keep getting that same message. I don't want to keep repeating myself, but it keeps coming through. With this death card, like I said, it feels like it's transformative. I do think it's going to kind of pop up out of nowhere, and it's going to like flip the script on you. Like you may thought your month or your days or your weeks were going to look like X, Y, and Z. And then this comes up and you're like, almost like hit the ground running energy, literally. I do think it's going to be definitely before the end of the month. It might be like the third week of the month. That's interesting that they're giving me a timeline. I usually don't get that. But I think it's going to be still in Scorpio season. It's going to be Scorpio season till I believe the 20th or the 21st of November before we switch to Sagittarius. So it's going to be before that. All right. You guys will have to keep me posted. All right, my Leos. Now, let's move into love messages. Thank you, Spirit, for those messages for my Leos. Can we get love messages for the single Leos, please, in the month of November, my single Leos? What do they got to know about? What's coming towards them, my single Leos? Messages for the single Leos in November, please. Oh, okay. We have the Two of Cups and the Knight of Swords. Interesting, you guys. If that situation wasn't work-related, that might be someone. That might be you guys dropping one in order to move in a different direction. So, you know. You are a Leo. You do get attention. I do see that there is someone coming up here, or with that Two of Cups. Interesting. This could be someone that you haven't walked away from. Things didn't move forward. It didn't work out before. It's still, the energy's still showing up though. Maybe you felt a really strong connection to this person. Things could have moved really quickly at one point. Why is this coming up? That's just for my single Leos. Yeah, this is someone that, or this is a situation that left you feeling very hopeless about things working out. Why the Two of Cups? Why the Knight of Swords? Why the Eight of Cups? Okay, this isn't someone else. This is how you view relationships, or how you view, maybe it's even a past relationship. Someone, if it's a past relationship, it's someone that you felt was a soulmate or you were connected to in a very, very strong way. So a couple of different stories. I'm going to cover for those of you that this is about a person. Someone here could have been emotionally immature, even though there is a strong connection. Because of the rate that things moved or the action that was required, it does feel like someone here did want to invest in this, but there's a message here of not walking away from repeating a cycle that didn't keep things moving forward. So that's if it's about a specific person, but I feel like for most of you, this is not about a specific person. This is about yourselves. So let's talk about that, because what's coming through is the way that we view relationships. There might be something that we're, I'm going to say, a little like emotionally immature, like not really viewing things maybe in a realistic way or in a way that is actually going to help you or serve you with whatever this blockage is. The blockage overall feels like it's moving forward or growing things or having hope again that things can work out. It's almost like there's a moment where you're, yes, hopeful, and then it goes back, because I'm also getting like mental health is coming through. So just, you know, take care of yourselves, my single Leos. But there's almost like maybe you're thinking back to things that were just kind of led to nothing. And that kind of leads to you feeling hopeless. It's almost like things that were said or petty behaviors. And here's this beautiful Empress, which this is like growth, fertility, opportunity, abundance. These are all the things we want to be in. If this is your energy, this is you choosing self-love. But at the same time, I'm not sure why it's wrapped up with all these other energies that aren't moving forward. I do feel like there's something here that you haven't fully walked away from. And yeah, it's like a lot. The burden of it. We have the Death card at the bottom of the deck. It's time for transformation. And that's also Scorpio season. So this month, you might be feeling like, you know, you're ready for a relationship, but at the same time, you're not very hopeful that things can move forward or, again, grow. It's almost like you're telling yourself, I'm not going to worry about it anymore. But at the same time, it is looming. And this feels, this, whatever, these thoughts, this energy, this feels like this is the repeating pattern that hasn't been left behind. This is also encouraging you to think about what it is that is important to you in a relationship, to really think about that. Maybe in the past you've moved into situations that, you know, you didn't really know what your priorities were, or even thought about that, or even brought them into consideration, perhaps. Maybe even swept away, and it just feels like I'm getting just like wind through your hair, like things just went quickly. But again, there's something here that hasn't, maybe you're not seeing the most clearly, or you haven't really thought of, maybe prioritizing emotional needs or something along those lines. I do see you keeping to yourselves and just kind of like avoiding. So I do feel like for most of you, these are thoughts you're going to be having. But just be aware that you're not like repeating a cycle that's just keeping you from being able to be happy. All right. Some of you could just like close off, which makes sense because that energy that we had at the beginning, it feels like a lot of you might be choosing to take on a project. All right. Thank you, Spirit, for those messages from my Leos. What about the connected Leos out there in the month of November, please? My Leos that are connected. Love messages for them, please, in the month of November. Messages for my connected Leos, please. All right, we have the Ace of Wands in reverse. We have the Page of Swords, the Page of Pentacles in reverse. Some of you could be just like, I don't know, maybe dealing with children or people that are younger than you. There's a lot of youthful energy coming through, but there's also like a loss of spark. You're also getting a message about mental health. There's just, it feels like maybe you have a lot of responsibilities this month. For those of you that have family, maybe this is what it is. Communicating, like people not getting back, someone not getting back, or someone not doing what they're supposed to. If this is kids, it's like having a hard time getting them to like clean their room or clean up after themselves or do their chores, like whatever it is. And it feels like you're just carrying it a lot by yourself. When it comes to your spark, it kind of feels like it's fizzles out this month. So just be aware of that, friends. I'm getting like burnout, even though this is the love part of your reading. For those of you, depending on how connected you are to someone, you know, this could be you doing things on your own. For those of you that your connection isn't like at the point where you share a home or routine, family, whatever it is, it still kind of feels that you're doing things off on your own. Maybe it even feels like you send messages or texts and someone doesn't get back to you right away. It's almost like the spark is going out. And I do feel that emotionally, you're not going to be very happy with things. Like you're going to be like, I feel single. And maybe some of you are single. Maybe if you guys aren't officially dating this person and you're just, you know, connecting to them, this is you sending more messages. And it's like someone here just doesn't let you get to know them better. Yeah, I feel you're not happy with the level of communication. That's for sure. You feel very connected here. And, you know, it's almost like, you know, that there's a deeper feeling here, but at the same time, it's like, you don't want this. And whatever's going on with your guys' messages or messaging, texting, DMing, whatever it is, however you communicate, it's repeating a pattern. Why the Page of Pentacles in reverse? Okay, so for those of you that the beginning part of your reading resonated with, did I say that that may have been a person? I don't even remember what I said. But anyway, this part might be connecting to that first part of the reading. If so, you're very attracted to this person, but it just doesn't feel like they're opening up. Now, this energy could also be you. If this is a new project that you're taking on or work or something, you're just kind of taking on a lot. But I kind of feel like this might be the person you're connecting to. Only you'll know, though. It just kind of feels like someone here has got their focus on something else, or they show up like, but it's to their convenience because they have, you know, work or a project or things that they do. And like I said, the way you guys communicate or whatever's going on here, it just feels repetitive. There might be an age difference between you guys. If there is not, then it's just coming, then it might just be talking about maturity level. Yeah, I do feel someone here is off on their own, doing things on their own, feeling single, independent, but at the same time, there's a feeling of conflict here, either because of that or this person gets a lot of attention, whoever is out there. If someone in the connection's out there acting single, it's almost like that creates conflict. That again, there's a message here of communication that it's just, you feel burdened by, you're okay. It's because you feel like you're the one that's always messaging, or you're the one that's trying to get this person's attention. That's also what I feel. I feel like you're fighting for this person's attention. And that's kind of gonna, like I said, I don't think that you're gonna feel good about it. This person's really fun to talk to. They're real flirty, but they just don't really make a move. They're holding back as well. It's like they're here for the good times. They don't want to get too serious. Someone here might be healing from something. But at the same time, because things or someone here isn't making a move or deciding what they want, it's almost like they're kind of ignoring something, or I don't know. Maybe I almost feel like someone here is hesitant for a second chance. That could be you. I mean, this could be a million chance. Whatever it is, though, you guys are going to be repeating something. All right, my Leo friends. Oh, I went on a roller coaster ride on that. I haven't been calling out signs for your reading. We have lots of Pisces coming through in this part. Cancer as well. All right, thank you, Spirit. Let's move into your bonus part of the read where we check in on you and whoever's on your mind, Aries through Pisces. Thank you, Spirit, Aries through Pisces. The person that my Leos are thinking about, Aries through Pisces. What can you tell me in the month of November, please? In the month of November, Aries through Pisces. If my Leos are dealing with an Aries, what can you tell us? There's no movement forward. Or someone here doesn't have plans for this to move forward. I don't see things progressing. Leo's dealing with a Taurus, please. Leo's dealing with a Taurus. Not committed, or just, yeah, maybe even acting selfishly in the situation, depending on what's going on. I don't really, if they're not around, I don't see them coming forward. They're not taking charge. Leo's dealing with a Gemini, please. Someone here wants healing or is healing, also remaining patient in the situation. I feel a sense of hope, honestly, when I pulled that. So if you're in disconnect, it feels like they want to heal this. Leo's dealing with a Cancer, please. Someone here is closing a chapter. There is a transformation happening within the connection. Only you'll know. If something is over, then it feels like it is. But if it's not, if you're not in a situation where this is over and you're still like connected to this person, it just feels like something's shifting within the connection during Scorpio season. All right. My Leo's dealing with a Leo. What was that that wanted to flip? They don't want to show me. Leo's dealing with a Leo. Expect messages, also keeping an eye on each other, possibly online or through people you know. But I do think messages will be coming through. Leo dealing with a Virgo. Someone here doesn't want this or lost the spark for this. Feels the passion is gone. Leo dealing with a Libra. The situation's really unfair, unbalanced. Maybe there's even a truth that hasn't been expressed. Actually, this is the Libra card too, so this is on their end. They're not feeling very balanced. The situation might feel it's unjust. Leo's dealing with a Scorpio. Leo's dealing with a Scorpio. There is an ending, or someone here is closing out a big chapter and they're starting to change their mind, or they're starting to view something differently here during this period of time. It feels like they've been in a transition for a while, but they're starting to, like I said, change their mind or view something differently. Leo's dealing with a Sagittarius. Someone here wants a new beginning, new love, new emotional beginning. It feels good. Leo's dealing with a Capricorn. Okay, you get two. someone here is avoiding this because they feel like things aren't mutual, like feelings aren't mutual, or someone cared too much or gave more to the situation. Leo's dealing with an Aquarius. Someone here is being stubborn or doesn't know a truth, is suppressing a truth. Things here aren't clear, that's for sure. I'm going to pull another one. Leo's dealing with Aquarius. Someone here has been withholding their truth. Yeah, someone here hasn't been truthful. They're hiding it. I'm getting it's fear-based. And Leo's dealing with a Pisces. Someone here is very emotional over this. I would say, I'm not sure if it's sad or just they're not feeling in control of their feelings. One more, please. Leo and Pisces. Oh, they're confused over how they feel. All right. They know they're attracted to you. All right, my Leo friends. Let's do the charms. I've just been spacing out in your reading, but like in a good way, like in a channeling way. Thank you, Spirit. Can we get some more messages for my Leos, please? Look at that. I was going to say, look at you. You got the Leo. You got the lion head. That is for you, my friends. We have Prince. I just thought of Dove's Cry. I also think of Little Red Corvette, right? Yeah. Oh my God, how could I forget that? That's because I was getting it crossed with Raspberry Beret. Jeez. I mean, all the good Prince songs. We have Squad. Again, you guys, I do feel like other people are going to be involved in, you know, I feel like you're going to be stepping back or choosing something else. And that might cause a little bit of conflict. So just like I said, don't say, I promise I'll be there. Even though you mean it, it may not end up happening. And that might trigger, you know, that might just trigger around you. We have the tacos with the heart. So maybe someone here is having tacos. And that's your reminder to hit up the taco truck. We have the Fool. So some of you, this could be unexpectedly meeting someone. And maybe that's, you're like, nope, I'm choosing to hang out with this person versus doing the thing that I said I was going to do. Whatever it is, though, it just feels like I said there is an energy of transformation that was coming through in your reading. I do think you are going to be feeling a shift in the next few weeks. We have Kim and Kanye. I guess I should get this one out of the selection, but it's actually come through a few times during November's horoscopes. So this could be about a toxic connection or something here. Like I said, maybe the way you view relationships, there's a little bit of, you know, negativity towards it, or you just have a hard time remaining hopeful because of experiences you've gone through. It just feels like because you haven't fully left something behind, it's just kind of affecting your present. So only you'll know what that is. We have the X from DMX with the bullet holes. Maybe this is a past situation that should be dead, done, and gone, but it's still, like I said, showing up to your present. And we have Saint Coco. So beautiful. I'm actually filming this on Dia de los Muertos. It is November 1st. So a reminder that you are guided. You are protected. You have, some of you, not everyone, have a feminine energy on the other side. That's one of your guides. My friends, that's what I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed your November horoscope reading. I'm wishing you nothing but the best. Sending you hugs for November. And I'll catch you at the next one. Thanks, guys. Hello, my Sagittarius friends, and welcome to your November horoscope reading. Friends, let's get right to it. As always, we're going to start with general messages, see what's coming up for you in the month of November. Then we'll be moving into the love reading. I'll be pulling cards for singles and those of you that are connected, and then we'll be doing a little bonus reading at the end where we check in on the person on your mind. All the way Aries to Pisces. So, and then, of course, doing a little charm reading at the end. Let's get right to it. As always, starting with a moment of gratitude. Thank you, Spirit, for allowing me to channel these messages today for the collective and allowing me to channel these messages for my Sagittarius friends. Spirit, for my Saggies, general messages in the month of November, please. What's coming up for my Saggies in November? What do they need to know about? What's coming up for my Saggies in November? some of you could have a new opportunity, a work opportunity, or something coming your way. We'll see what that's about. What can you tell me, please, for my Saggies general messages? We have the Ten of Pentacles. I love it. A focus on your stability, your home, your family, the thing you've invested into, the thing that's going to be there for you years from now. Very solid, committed energy. What's coming up for my Saggies, please? We have the Star card. Wow. Okay. This is very beautiful energy. Not for everyone. For some of you, this could have to do with family traditions. I was going to say customs. Maybe that's what it is, traditional customs that you guys may have. There's just something here with this Hierophant card. This is very, and the family card, I'm just getting like there's just something very meaningful going on. For some of you, this could even be a wedding. Doesn't have to be. Whatever the event is, it's very healing. There's healing that's brought to the situation. So if in the past you were disappointed, I do feel like this month you are going to be releasing that. It feels like you're feeling hopeful. You're feeling good. Some of you could be getting promoted after a period of time. Maybe you hit the books or you did some kind of course study or some kind of preparation. Maybe for some of you, this is even a ceremony of some sort. It feels like you're being seen, you're being recognized. Very wise in the situation. You've worked really hard for this, and I feel like you doubted yourself along the way. But I feel like that's coming to an end by the Ten of Pentacles. Very beautiful energy. Yeah, so whatever this is, it's whenever, like whatever rough time you were having, if it was a financial loss or not having enough or feeling left out, there's just a recovery from that. And whatever this recovery is, it feels like it's really good and it's really stable. This has been a long time coming, or some time coming, I should say. And it's like, you knew that this was going to happen. You knew you were going to work up to this, and then here you are. Why the Hierophant, please? Yes, you're going to be speaking. So for some of you, this is you using your voice. You went from student to master or to teacher, you know. For some of you, this is even your, this is weird. Maybe you're the ordained minister. Maybe you're the one, what is that called? When you're ordained to like perform weddings, like that's the vibe that I'm getting. I'm getting that there's a ceremony and you're the one speaking. Why the Three of Swords in reverse? And people listen. So in the past, things that didn't take off or not being able to start new, whatever that was, you're getting out of that. It's like November, you're on this trajectory that feels really awesome. I'm going to say, my Saggies, you're literally the one of the two that got the best horoscopes for November. Because I do feel like you worked for this and you knew it was coming. You're no longer upset or disappointed over what was, what wasn't. Now, you've worked really hard for this, and at times it's almost like you lost sight of why you were doing it or what you loved about it. But I think it's because your head was just in it. You were really like, what is that? I'm using metaphors I don't even know how to say. Anyway, you were working real hard. We have the Devil card in reverse with the Strength card in reverse. So I do feel like this was, I'm not going to say self-sabotaging because, you know, you still went ahead and did your thing. But this was almost like depressive energy or like self-brought doubts that you're like trying to release or you have released yourself from. They keep saying things are getting better. Things are getting better because you kept going. Some of you might even be traveling. I am seeing movement, but more than anything, I just see that you're making progress and things are, you're on the up and up. I love it. We have Capricorn, Leo, Taurus, Aquarius, Aries and Aquarius as well coming through. All right, my Saggy friends, those are your general messages. Now let's move into the love portion. Thank you, Spirit. What about my single Saggies, please? Love messages for the single Sagittarius collective in November, please. Messages for my single Saggies. Love messages for my single Sagittarius friends, please, Spirit, in November. Love messages, please, for my single Saggies. So some of you aren't receiving communication. Maybe you got in an argument or this is coming up for you in November. This could be predicting. If it's an argument, it almost feels petty. If it's not hearing from someone, someone here is playing games with how they communicate with you. Maybe you're both kind of playing games. Single Saggies, please. Yeah, you're really not liking that you're not getting the attention that you want, but you're also not walking away. You still want to invest into this. So there's a situation, someone that you're interested in, and you're not happy with the communication. Again, I almost feel like someone here is just playing games, and you're disappointed. Because it feels like you're invested, you care, and you want to continue to invest. Someone here is definitely holding back. They're not talking, and it feels like there's no balance in the situation. So this person uses someone here is manipulative. They pull back communication as a way to manipulate. And even though you want to invest, I feel like this is quite a burden. Someone here is purposely ignoring you, and maybe they give you just enough to kind of keep you in the energy with this Queen of Wands in reverse and the Three of Swords. I don't know. Maybe there's another person involved. They just showed me. It's like wanting to release this. They're showing me lots of queens, you guys. I just saw another one. I'd be careful of this person. What can you tell me about this person for my single Saggies, please? Yeah, set your boundaries. If they come back around, or if you want them to come back around and you approach them, because I feel like you're still wanting to invest here. You just have to set your boundaries. Something here is not making you happy. So even though this is singles, it definitely feels like there's a presence here. Yeah, because it feels like you're not getting enough attention, or you're feeling left out, you're feeling lonely. Now, if there is absolutely no one in your energy, then this is you getting in your feels over not getting attention or not having anyone to like talk to. Maybe your phone's dry and you're really trying to figure out what's important to you, but it feels like it's more of a burden than anything. Maybe you feel like everything you encounter out there is just mind games. Some of you could be taking a hit on your confidence, or you're just kind of moody or just like upset over it. I am getting the sense that someone here is upset, but it's still not being able to leave this behind. Again, attention is really coming through, or lack thereof, my friends. Someone here is not happy with the level of attention that they're getting. We have Libra, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, Aries, Saggy over here, Aries and Leo as well, Virgo. All right. Let's move on to my connected Saggies. Thank you, Spirit. Saggies, your messages have been so like straight to the point. It's wild. Thank you, Spirit, for these messages for my Saggies. It's probably because Saggies don't have the patience to sit here and not get messages straight to the point. Messages for my connected Saggies, please. In November, love messages for my Sagittarius friends that are connected. What can you tell us? Love messages for my connected Saggies, please. All right. We have the King of Wands. We have the Hanged Man in reverse. So someone here could be changing their mind or viewing their partner differently. This could be you. This could be them. Maybe something that you originally wanted or a new journey, a new chapter that you guys wanted to take. You're starting to change your mind about it. Yeah. So some of you could just be focusing on your work or re-looking at, I almost said reprioritizing, maybe. I don't know. There's just something about work that's coming through here. Also, just beware random little bickering around the home is coming through. And that type of bickering, even though it starts small and it's not consistent or it's just here and there, enough of that will just take the spark out, kill the passion. So just beware. I wasn't going to pull those out. Actually, let me put them like this. Yeah. Because I feel like all of these are together. All right. Why this King of Wands, please? Why this King of Wands? You may feel, or you, that someone here is choosing work over the partnership, or you guys just aren't seeing eye to eye. Someone here is very passionate and driven I feel like it's their goals, like whatever goal they have, it could be work. And that kind of causes a little wedge between you guys. I do see that you are going to start changing your mind and realize that it's a matter of time, or I feel like there's just a time and you're like, okay, you kind of realize that. There's also realizing that something new can't happen because someone here doesn't have the commitment, dedication, consistency for it yet. So it's almost like choosing to rest instead of trying to force anything. Why the Eight of Pentacles? Yeah, I'm telling you guys, someone here is really going to be wrapped up in work. They might have a new project that they're working on or a new something, startup, I don't know. I'm going to say it again. Watch what you guys say, because enough of that little bickering energy, and it does have the potential to kind of just create little conflict that doesn't need to be there, or burnout situations. Maybe someone here is even a little like, isn't very mindful as to what they say around the home because their head is at work or something. Connection-wise, though, everything seems good there with this union card, this lover's card. Even though, like I said, it's almost like it takes a change in your how you view something, how you think of something, how you see something, maybe a different perspective, and you're like, okay, it's a matter of time. Again, the message of just kind of hold back certain things that you want to say because it's really not leading you to a better place. I don't see anyone walking away at this point. Communication is going to be an issue. That's for sure. That's the strongest message that's coming through for you guys, is that communication might be an issue this month. Whether something is misspoken, someone takes something the wrong way, there's misunderstandings. Be careful if this is over text message. Someone might literally misinterpret like the tone. You know how sometimes we are dealing with our day, and if we're in a stressful situation or something like that, and someone texts us, it's almost like we might apply what we're going through to that and think that someone is attacking us and all they asked us is, what do we want for dinner? Something like that. So just be mindful of that, my Saggies babies. We have Aries, Virgo, Cancer. We have all the signs, Gemini, Leo coming through. All right. Thank you, Spirit. Now, let's see. Let's check in on the person on your mind, all the way from Aries to Pisces, for your bonus reading. Thank you, Spirit, for these messages from my Sagittarius friends. Aries to Pisces, what can you tell us, please? What can you tell my Saggy friends in the month of November? If my Saggies are dealing with an Aries, what can you tell us about November, please? Someone here is getting over it or getting over something. They were sad, but they're finally in recovery from that. If my Saggies are dealing with a Taurus, Sagittarius dealing with a Taurus, They feel like you guys have gone through a lot, but they're not giving up. They feel wounded in the situation, but they're still persevering. I'm getting the sense that they still see opportunity for growth here. Or maybe they feel like they've invested enough. You guys have invested enough. Sagittarius dealing with a Gemini. I feel like this might be your energy. That is Sagittarius energy. They're losing patience. And they have someone here needs to be grounded about this. I feel like the situation is just not grounded and someone here is struggling with having patience. Sagittarius dealing with a Cancer. Someone here doesn't want it or the passion has gone out. The spark has gone out. Sagittarius dealing with a Leo. Someone doesn't feel in their power, but more than anything, beware of manipulative energy here. Someone might be trying to manipulate the situation. Sagittarius dealing with a Virgo. Someone here is disappointed, heartbreak. Maybe there's a third party situation. They're in pain. Even though they feel they're doing the right thing. Whatever the right thing was, it brought pain. Sagittarius dealing with a Libra. That's funny because that's the Libra card. So we'll take that in between Virgo and Libra. That could be for the Libra as well. But this is the card that came out for the Libra. They're in love or they love you. Someone here cares a lot and is very understanding. Sagittarius dealing with Scorpio. There's bad memories here. They're thinking of the bad times. Sagittarius dealing with a Sagittarius. They've lost hope or they're having a hard time remaining hopeful in the situation. Sagittarius dealing with a Capricorn, please. They're ignoring this or ignoring you. They might even be playing aloof. Sagittarius dealing with an Aquarius. Things aren't moving forward or they're not coming forward. Sagittarius dealing with a Pisces. One more. They're viewing this relationship different. They don't feel like you guys are on the same page or there's no union here. They might be changing their mind as well. All right, let's pull some charms for you before we wrap up your reading. Thank you, Spirit, for these messages for my Sagittarius friends. What else can you tell my Sagittarius, please? Messages for Sagittarius in November. All right, let's see. Well, the first and foremost is gigantic death card. Death and transformation. There might be something transforming for you. And I think that there is, friends, because it seems like you guys are coming on the up and up when it comes to your finances, your health, your home, your relationships, whatever it is. It feels like there had to be a necessary shift where you had to experience some type of low point or down, like, you know, we all have highs and lows and you had to deal with the low in order to start coming up to this high. I do feel that it is coming though. We have LA. Maybe someone is from LA or those initials mean something to someone. We also have La Nalgona, a reminder to love yourself just as you are, self-confidence as well. Maybe someone likes your booty for those of you that have someone to be around that likes your booty. We have the Night King. This to me is like that King of Swords. Maybe someone here has gone cold or emotionally detached. We have Sadness wearing the cure. Maybe someone here has been in their feels because there's been a tough time that's had. I'm getting the sense of feeling the cold, being left out in the cold. We have the Pot Leaf from The Chronic 2001. Maybe that album means something to someone. That's Dr. Dre. Maybe someone here just likes The Chronic. Maybe someone just got The Chronic delivered. I don't know. Just saying. That happens in the state that I'm from, for those of you not from here. We have Do Not Disturb. So someone could be taking time to themselves. Maybe that's even a reminder for you to take time to yourself this month. We have Frida. Maybe someone here is into the arts or is a fan of Frida. Maybe recently you went to Mexico. And we have the party animal raccoon. This to me is Saggy energy. Why? Because you like to have a good time and you can't be tamed. I absolutely love it. Maybe someone here has recently seen a raccoon. Totally random, but if you do happen to see a raccoon, that might be a sign for you. Maybe that's one of the synchronicities. I didn't mention this. It actually didn't come up in your reading, but right now synchronicities are coming up. Maybe you guys have seen signs along the way that are telling you that things are getting better, or you already feel it. Anyway, friends, that's what I have for you today. I hope you enjoyed your November horoscope reading, friends. I'm wishing you nothing but the best, and I'm sending you hugs for November. And I'll catch you at the next one. Thanks, guys.